Mr. Jaworski?
Jaworski. War. Like warrior, there's no T.
Sorry about that. I appreciate you meeting me like this.
I hope this won't take long. You know, with the reopening and all, I've got a lot of work on my plate. Huh?
Oh, I see. That was a joke. Some people go in for that sort of thing. Let's see. You're the owner of Pepe's Pub in Jamestown?
That's right.
I thought Jamestown was in Virginia.
You know, occasionally there are cities which have the same name in different states.
I thought they always put the word new in front of it if that was the case. You know, like New York. Anyways, the health department is reaching out to businesses around the states to make sure health protocols are being followed during this unprecedented pandemic.
I'm sorry, pandemic? Can you explain? I haven't heard of it.
Oh, well, ever since March, we... Is that another one of your jokes?
Can't get anything by Albany. Do you mind if we hurry this along? They certainly don't call it Zoom because the meetings are zippy. Never mind. Pepe's Pub will be forever in your debt.
According to the first 14 executive orders to come out of Albany...
Only 14?
It's only been 4 months. We've streamlined the process during
this... unprecedented pandemic.
Let's get right to it. First and foremost, there are to be no walk-up beverage purchases at your pub.
Come again?
No one can walk up to the bar and order a drink.
Why's that?
Because that's what the executive order states.
So drinking a beer is okay, but a person can't walk up to the bar and order a beer. Is that right?
Precisely. Your bartender will have to go to the tables and take their order.
What about ice cream stands?
I'm sorry?
It's summertime. Jamestown has a lot of ice cream stands. You know, you walk up to the counter and you ask for a twist dipped in chocolate. It's a summertime tradition here. Is that still allowed?
Yes, of course. Ice cream stands have counters, not bars.
So if I rename my bar to a counter, will that be acceptable?
Certainly not. Beer sits on a bar, not a counter.
When I'm in my house and I put a tub of ice cream on the counter and then I remove it and put a six-pack of beer on the counter instead, does it then become a bar?
Mr. Jaworski, we do not have jurisdiction over residential matters.
But I bet you sure as heck would like to.
Can we get back to your establishment? Do you understand the rules concerning the purchasing of drinks? The bartender, or whomever, must go to the individual tables, wearing a mask, of course, and take drink orders.
Let me ask you a question. What's the purpose of all this?
So that less people are moving around in the bar. That will help stop the spread of the virus.
Oh, I see. You want less people moving around, but you're okay with my two bartenders skipping to every corner of the bar. Everyone in the bar should only be linked together through my bartenders, is that right?
Precisely.
So, rather than having a customer's COVID germs being passed at the bartender will be the common link which spreads everyone's germs to everyone else.
Precisely.
This is such a great idea.
I'm glad you think so. You understand now.
These are the clearest instructions out of Albany all week. People come into my bar, they sit at a table, and they order drinks.
Oh, but not just drinks, they must order food as well.
What do you mean?
They cannot just order alcohol, they must order food too.
People don't come into Pepe's Pub for the cuisine. They come to get smashed so they can forget about their crappy lives and all the government overreach coming out of Albany. Oh yeah, that's right. Your boss is a popular topic of conversation around here.
Well, we encourage public engagement.
Oh, the people are engaged. They are engaged and enraged and ready to stage a COVID coup.
Well, if they do so, they must do it with food.
Why?
Because that's what the executive order states.
Is there anything else?
Just the regular. Masks, hand sanitizer, 70% alcohol, mind you.
That won't be a problem. Everything in my bar is made out of at least 70% alcohol.
Good. Is that...
Yes. That was a joke. I'm a funny guy.
We may follow up at any time, and mind you, failure to implement these health protocols could result in a fine and or loss of your business permit.
Masks, sanitizer, no bar, and food. I'm all over it.
Good day, Mr. Jaworski.
I did everything they asked. Were they happy? Is Albany ever happy? A week later, I get an invite for a follow-up Zoom call. Oh, goody. Can't wait.
Mr. Jaworski!
There's no T.
Jaworski, I have received a disturbing report about your establishment.
Now what?
COVID chips?
Yes, COVID chips. Pretty clever, right? Before anyone can order a beer from one of my bartenders who walked the entire way from the bar past every other table in the joint, they have to order a mandatory serving of COVID chips. I came up with that. To meet Albany's food requirement. You're impressed, aren't you?
Mr. Jaworski, this seems like a blatant attempt to skirt around the spirit of the law.
I'm not skirting around any spirit. They can order spirits, and lift their spirits, and freaking summon the spirits for all I care, as long as they plop down a dollar for the COVID chips before ordering any beer as required by Albany.
I am here to tell you, in no uncertain terms, that chips and fries do not, let me repeat, do not qualify for the food requirement. Therefore, if you do not rectify the situation ASAP, your establishment will be in violation of the executive order, and we will be forced to shut you down.
You gotta be kidding.
I do not kid. We will be sending an inspector tomorrow. If COVID chips are not replaced with a qualifying substitute food, you...
Yeah, I get it. And I hope the Zoom portal zaps you in the rear on the way out. I always thought it would be rewarding to run my own business, make my own decisions, be my own boss. Be my own boss. I am going to refrain from everything I want to say right now. Younger people who have idealistic views of capitalism might be listening, and I don't want to crush their hope in the American dream. Who am I kidding? Do young people like that even exist anymore? You want to know what happened? Play the game. You followed their rules. That should have been enough, right? Oh, no. No. There's always another Zoom call on the horizon. God help us all.
Mr. Jaworski!
What is it now?
Mr. Jaworski, I am rather shocked at this whole circumstance. You seem to be a good fellow, a compliant fellow, and yet you go and you pull a stunt like this.
Like what? I've been the most patient and compliant bar owner in the state, but that's about to end.
Our inspector visited Peppy's pub yesterday, and she relayed the shocking details. Frankly, I just... of all things.
What are you talking about?
You know what I'm talking about. Chicken wings? Chicken wings?
Chicken wings?
You blatantly went behind our guidelines and replaced your COVID chips with chicken wings. How could you? The governor has made it very clear that chicken wings do not, let me repeat, do not meet the minimum requirement for substitute food for bars.
Chicken wings are not food?
Chicken wings do not meet the requirement.
In what way don't they meet the requirement? Do you mean that chicken wings are strictly forbidden in the executive
order? Of course not. They just can't be served alone with beer in this COVID environment. Don't you watch the governor's press conferences?
Never miss one. Live my life by them.
Well, you must have missed yesterday's. He stated very clearly that the lowest level of substitute food that would be acceptable in bars would be a sandwich.
Sandwich?
Your patrons must at least order a sandwich before they can order a beer.
I have a question for you.
Yes.
Is this based on science?
Mr. Jaworski, everything we do is based by science. We are trying to stop the spread of this unprecedented pandemic.
And COVID loves chicken wings, but hates sandwiches.
We all have to do our part. Do I have your word that you will start to abide by these crucial guidelines to stop the spread?
And if I don't serve sandwiches?
Then you don't serve alcohol.
Masks on, 6 feet apart, no bar ordering, no COVID chips, no chicken wings. Sandwiches are okay.
Sandwiches are the minimum.
Which means sandwiches are okay.
They are the minimum.
The minimum is sufficient.
The minimum is the minimum.
And is there a minimum number of times that I have to talk to you? Please tell me we have reached our
maximum.
I hope
this is the last. Good day, Mr. Jaworski.
Be my own boss, I said. It will be rewarding. I will get to choose to set my own agenda, not have anyone on my back. You know, as TJ said, life, liberty, and the pursuit of happiness. Might be easier to just give up. But you know what? I don't think that would make me happy. You know what would make me happy? Sandwiches. I'm thinking of adding a line of gourmet sandwiches to my bar. Yes, this is what I'm going to do. This is my newest creation. Peanut butter and jelly squares. The perfect balance of nuttiness and sweetness before drinking an IPA or a blonde ale. Heck, it can even go with a pilsner. So, if you're coming to my bar, you'll need to order one of these minimally substantive, government-approved sandwiches prior to ordering your beer. That way, we will be compliant, because I've been told that sandwiches are the most basic level of substantive food that will help bars stop the spread of this unprecedented pandemic. You want to know the best part? My PB&J squares are only 25 cents each. Uh-oh. I'm getting another Zoom call. This could get ugly.
Mr. Jaworski!
Co-op, the mother effers!
Can you move?
Why? You want me to rescue you?
No. Oh my god, no.
Are there two of you?
Are you talking to me?
I hear you both, but you only seem to hear me.
My turn to
Who
speak.
Is speaking?
Quiet, both of you. Stay calm.
You're not.
I'm Grace. What are your names?
Stupid Tina.
Ellie and Stupid Tina?
Oh God, did I say that out loud?
Elle and not Ellie, wise ass.
You meant just Tina, right?
We'll be dead by the time you get our names right.
Okay, now we're getting somewhere.
Could you really say that?
Don't speak unless I call your name.
How about you speak when I call your name?
I don't think you get the idea.
It's not worth getting.
Wait a minute. I remember you. You were yelling at somebody. Purple hair, right?
Lavender.
I miss her.
Yes. Elle has the purple hair. And so, Tina, what were you doing in the bank?
I was going to find out if I had even one account with my name on it.
Well, where were you at the explosion?
I was helping an old man pick up his pennies at the door.
That was nice of you. Those pennies went everywhere.
Do you think he's okay? You probably won't be able to find a single penny now.
You think we might want to talk about something more important than pennies? Jesus!
Sorry, I'm scared too.
I didn't say I was scared.
Did Elle say I was scared?
No. Elle just said it was a kind thing you did for the old man.
Yeah, sure. I didn't mind frying outside while you picked up 8,000 pennies.
I see no need for you to be so hostile. Tina can't even hear you, so why bother being so mean?
Admit it!
What are you talking about?
The only reason you remembered seeing me is because it was surprising to you that the fat lady bothered with purple hair and a nose stud. What's the point, right?
Believe it or not, half the women under 40 in this town have purple hair and jewelry in a disgusting place.
And the other half are just fat. God. Oh, God. She can't hear me, right?
Take the chip off your shoulder before somebody puts it somewhere equally disgusting.
Late. I got a diamond stud there.
What the hell is wrong with you two? We're trapped underground, and you two are acting like it's Saturday night at the bar and time to see who has the bigger you-know-what.
Not bad, lady.
I wasn't trying to be rude. I really wasn't.
It's okay, Tina. I see now you didn't mean it.
Well, what the hell did she say?
Well, who cares?
Not me. So what do we do?
Wait until somebody rescues us.
We will suffocate before they get here.
No, we won't. We're alive now, so the odds are good we'll stay alive. I read that somewhere.
Well, that's good enough for me, as long as you read it somewhere. It's a lock.
What is that slurping noise? Oh, God. There's no water coming in, is there? Oh, God.
Relax. It's me chewing gum. I chew and I'm, you know, a little bit not scared, but nervous.
Oh, God, I have a pain in my chest.
Try slowing your breathing down. The pain might stop.
I've got a couple pains in my ass.
That's not very helpful.
God, what did she say?
Stay still and quiet. Don't use too much oxygen.
God, I really am bleeding from somewhere.
Can you tell where?
I think I'm having a miscarriage.
Oh, God.
What's the matter?
Tina thinks she's had a miscarriage.
That guinea bitch?
I was only a couple of months, Grace.
Oh, I'm so sorry, Tina. Can you still hear me? She's crying, Elle.
No. God, I mean, yes, I'm crying, but it's not because of the, it's complicated.
Okay, focus on breathing slowly. In, out, in.
Can we skip the yoga lesson?
We need to save our air.
No, we need to shout so the firemen will know we're down here.
Exactly why we need to stop talking and save our oxygen.
We're gonna die.
You're not gonna die, Tina.
Unless we have to wait more than about an hour, after which I think she's right.
Tina, Elle thinks we need to yell so somebody will hear us. I think that uses up too much air to do that. You want to weigh in?
I wonder if my husband will even notice I'm not there anymore.
We're not going to die. Now tell me, save our air or yell for help?
Got a beautiful house, lots of fancy clothes, expensive vacations, but all I can think is maybe this is a godsend.
Don't you dare say that.
What did she say?
Focus, Tina.
God, yell. Yell. I want to yell. I would rather go down yelling than suffocate quietly. Been doing that my whole life.
Elle, Tina's on your side.
Wouldn't it make sense that the one who can hear both of us has the best chance of being heard?
But I think I can hear both of you because I'm between you. You sound like you're above me, Elle. Closest to the surface, I mean.
Great. For us, great. I yell and die.
Listen, I'm not that opposed to yelling on principle. It's just that I have asthma. I start yelling, I'm going to be in trouble long before the two of you are.
But maybe you hear us.
I'm not worth yelling
to a vent that could send your voice out to the surface.
It would be too big a risk. And well, I'm not a big risk taker. I'd already been in the bank for over an hour trying to decide whether to cash in a CD or not so I can buy a newer car than my O2. It has 123,000 miles on it. What is wrong with me?
No risk, no gain.
No risk, no pain.
Tell Elle I want to yell.
Goddamn poetry slam going on.
For you, not her.
Sometimes taking no risk is a bigger risk. You ever think of that?
Did you tell Elle I want to yell?
Elle, Tina's on your side.
We'll yell our lungs out. Maybe for real. Jesus, you never think things like this happen in real life.
God, I feel like I'm in a Lifetime movie.
A miracle. You two agree.
I never wait for a hammer to fall or pink slip to come or boyfriend to dump me or somebody to make me feel too fat to live. I strike first.
And if you had known ahead of time that this was going to happen, who would you have struck?
I don't mean the explosion. Yelling instead of waiting, that's striking first.
Well, this has nothing to do with your insecurities, but go ahead.
At least I know I'm alive.
God. Well, then this may surprise you, Elle, but I'm going to yell too. I don't want to spend what's left of the rest of my life feeling guilty that I didn't save you in time because I waited quietly in the little box I call my life.
No worry about regrets. We'll probably all die anyway.
Little Miss Sunshine. But what about those few seconds of my last breath when I know what I've done?
Dear Lord, please... please forgive me for talking about a godsend and for not being as sad as I should be about the baby. God, I wish I could be. And please forgive Elle and Grace.
Come on, we're wasting time.
Amen.
Tina was saying a prayer.
We'll ask her whether she's praying to the same God that put us here.
Wait.
Tina, what's the matter?
I don't want you to yell. Please, don't. Please, let me do this for you. Tell Elle what I said.
What is happening?
Tina just asked me not to yell.
Oh, holy crap. Thank God, I don't want you to yell either. My grandma has asthma too, but I didn't want to seem like a pussy.
Not this time. This time, a risk feels right. It feels wanted. Like hope.
All right. All together then.
Three.
Two.
Thank you. Video call from Ricky.
Oh, geez, here we go again.
What do we do?
Well, what choice do we have? We have to answer.
We can get through this. We'll just do our best. You remember how we did it last time, right?
Well, not exactly, but we'll wing it.
Oh, dear.
Hold on.
Can you see us?
No.
Can you see us?
No, Mom.
Why isn't he answering?
Well, maybe he can't see us.
There you go. There you go.
I can't hear you. Turn on your mic.
My mic is on.
Why won't he turn on his mic now?
It's on.
I can't hear him. Can you hear him? I can't hear a thing.
Turn on your mic.
Is your volume up?
Can you read lips? We cannot hear you. We can see you, but we cannot hear you.
Can you hear us? Can you hear us?
Yes, I hear you. Loud and clear.
Huh? What? Hello?
I hear you.
I don't know. Is it working?
Oh, we don't know. We don't know, Rick.
Turn up your volume.
Oh, how about this? How's this, Rick? Is this better?
Is this better? I can't talk any louder. I have a sore throat already.
Yeah. Your mother has a sore throat. She can't talk any louder, otherwise she'll strain her throat again. Don't strain your throat again. I don't want her to strain her throat again. Turn up the volume on your computer.
I think he wants us to turn up the volume on the computer.
On our computer?
Yes. Yes.
He's saying yes.
Oh, where's the volume button?
I don't see one.
Oh, we don't
really?
See one.
Every time.
I think he's getting frustrated with us. Are you getting frustrated with us, honey?
No, Ma. No, I'm just trying to get you to... What? Why am I talking to them?
Why
they can't hear
talking?
Me.
We can't hear you, kiddo. The phone's ringing, honey.
Is that the phone ringing?
I just said the phone's ringing.
Should I get it?
Well, we can't have two conversations at once. Just let it go to voicemail. Oh, what's that? Oh, you have a call too? Maybe we should call you back.
Why is he pointing at his phone?
Maybe he has a call.
Do you have a call, honey? Do you need to go?
I'm calling you. He says he's calling us.
I know. We can see you, but we can't hear you.
The phone's ringing again, honey.
I'll get it. You keep trying.
What am I trying?
Hello?
Yeah, it's me.
Who?
Me, Ricky.
Oh, Ricky, honey, it's so good to hear your voice finally.
You can hear him? I still can't hear him.
He's on the phone.
Oh, he's on the phone now. Oh, maybe we should try this again later.
I'm on the phone with you.
What's he saying?
He says he's on the phone with you.
Who?
Wants me to put him on speakerphone.
So put him on speakerphone.
I put you on speakerphone, honey.
Is that you, Ricky?
Hi, Dad.
Oh, hi. Now I can hear you. Why don't you just call on the telephone to begin with?
You need to learn how to do this. We don't talk often enough, and with everything going on, I want to be in touch with you guys, and I want us to be able to see each other when I call. That's why.
We can see you just fine. We can't hear you. That's the problem.
You can't hear me.
We can hear you now, but we couldn't before.
That's because the volume's not up on the computer.
The volume's not up on your computer?
On your computer!
How do you know the volume's not up on our computer?
How do I know? Ask him.
I was asking him. How do you know the volume's not up on our computer?
Because if it was, you'd be able to hear me.
We can hear you fine, honey.
You can hear me on the phone because I called you.
Oh, thanks for calling, buddy. How's everything? Yeah, you need anything?
No, I'm good. Just wanted to call and talk for a while.
Your voice doesn't match the picture. Does his voice match the picture?
No, it's out of sync.
It's out of sync.
That's what I just said.
It's like watching an old movie that's dubbed and the lips are moving different than the words.
That's because there's a buffering delay.
I don't know what that means.
It means there's a delay, dear. There's a delay, right, Ricky?
Can you make them the same speed, honey, so the words and the pictures match?
They will match if you turn up your volume.
Turn up the volume, dear.
How's that? Is that better?
Is that better, Ricky?
You need to turn up the volume on your computer.
I just did.
You turned up the volume on your phone.
How's everything, honey?
Oh, fine, Mom. How are you guys?
Oh, we're doing good, Ricky. How are you? You need anything? We're just fine.
Good, good.
What was that now?
There's another call. We have another call.
We have another call, Ricky. Should we get it? Should we get it?
I don't know. Should we get it?
I don't know if you want to.
Pick it up. It may be important. We're going to put you on hold for a minute, okay?
Maybe I should go.
Hold on a minute, honey. I'm sure it's not important.
Well, what? We can't assume that. What if it is important?
What could be so important?
I should really get going.
In day and age, anything could be important. It could be anything, now more than ever.
Hold on a minute, honey. One of us should get it.
Okay, so get it. Push the button. Your mother's getting the other call. What are you waiting for? Push the button.
I thought you were pushing it.
I just told you to push the button.
You don't have to get cross.
I'm not getting cross.
You sound cross.
You're just holding the phone in your hand. You're the one.
One of you push the goddamn button.
I agree.
So push
it. All you have to do is push the button.
I don't know why you have to tell me.
I can't be pushing the button if you're holding the phone.
I can't.
I don't know why you have to tell me.
I'm telling you guys. I'll call you next weekend. I'll call you next weekend. We will try again. Goodbye.
So it's not a contest to see who's going to pick it up. Just pick it up.
You, I don't like your tone. You pick it up.
Wait. Hold on. I think he's gone. I think Ricky ended the call.
You sure? Ricky. Yep. We lost him.
Thank God. Finally.
Finally.
Time?
6 minutes.
That's 6 minutes of life we'll never get back.
Not too bad.
Last week we got rid of him in 5.
He's becoming too patient with us. We've got to frustrate him more so he stops calling altogether.
Pretending that we're bumbling computer illiterate dummies isn't frustrating enough. What else can we do?
Maybe we can have the cat walk back and forth over the keyboard next time.
He likes the cat too much. He'll keep him on even longer.
God forbid. We can just change our number.
Too obvious. He'll figure it out.
What other choice do we have?
It's constant with that one.
I know. It's like every Sunday he has to check in.
He has to.
What does he think? We want to talk to him every single Sunday?
Like we have nothing better to do?
Can't he just get a girlfriend to talk to?
Or a boyfriend, even.
Just any friend. He has to get one. Maybe then he'll give us some space.
Your mouth to God's ears. Can't even quarantine in peace anymore.
So annoying. Anyway. Pornhub or video poker?
How about video poker and then Pornhub?
I like the way you think.
He better not call back.
One can only hope.